Hello everyone, in this video lesson we'll be having the Casio CG50. In this video lesson we'll be having the Casio CG50, the graphic calculator of Casio, the top of the line graphic utility. And we will be exploring this calculator and at the same time connecting it with the content in K-12 curriculum in the subject is calculus. Okay, let's have this topic, the equation of the tangent to a curve. So we all know that the slope of the line tangent to a function f of x at a given point AB is given by this expression. So m, the slope of the tangent line subscript TL, is equal to d over dx f of x evaluated at x equals a. Let's have this problem to solve. What is the equation of the line tangent to y equals 2 square root 25 minus x squared at the point negative 3a? First, it's important to notice that the given point negative 3a is a point on the curve. And it's easy to see that if you substitute negative 3 to x, you get 8. So to solve this, we need to get the slope of the tangent line as shown earlier. This one is mtl d over dx f of x equals 8. So we can actually do that by using the Rand matrix mode. We have solution 1. I'll show you how to get the slope using the Rand matrix mode. So to go to the Rand matrix mode, press menu and use the cursors to go to mode number 1 or Rand matrix. To go to the mode, just press X and we'll be in this mode. So you see, this is the calculator part of the CG50. It's a graphing calculator, but of course, it's still a calculator. So to evaluate the slope at negative 3/8 using the formula, this one, so just input this d over dx of 2 square 25 minus x squared, and then at x equals negative 3. So press option, and then see this calc here. So to access this, the button to use is just below it is F4. And then d over dx would be the second. To get to that, get F2. So you see, d over dx will appear on the screen and all we need to do is input the expression. So 2 shift square root 25 minus x squared. And then using the arrow keys to go to that empty slot for our value of x, input negative 3, and press exit to execute the operation, we'll get 1.5. What does this mean? Means that the slope of the function at the point negative 3/8 is 1.5 or 3/2. Now we know that the slope is 1.5 and then or 3/2. Therefore, the equation of the tangent is y equals 3/2 x plus 25 over 3. Now, of course, this is a graphic utility, so we can actually graph this to our given function and the tangent line to see if they are really tangents. So press menu. So the primary function of the graphic calculator is, of course, this mode, graph mode number 5. So press exit to get to the mode. And you will see this will appear on your screen. So you're asked to graph a function in terms of y in terms of x. So these are all y in terms of x. And notice that there are up to 20 functions that you can input. And let's input the given function to y1. So again, the function given, so I'll just show it to you again, is 2 square root 25 minus x squared. 2 square root 25 minus x squared, press exit. Now notice that after pressing the exit button, the highlighted row is now in Y2, in this highlighted red row here. It means you are asked to input another function if you want to. So if you don't want to, then just grab the function that you inputted in Y1, just press draw. And which is to access that, you press F6, and then the graph will appear. So it's actually a curve. So let's fix the window first. So I'll go back to the initial window because I'm expecting here a semi-ellipse. So there, so it's in the correct window. So let's zoom out so you can see. So there, it's a semi-ellipse. Okay, now let's see the point negative 3/8. Where is the point negative 3/8 on this graph? So press shift and then the trace function and just input negative 3 and it will go to that point. So you see that it's the point negative 3/8. So we answered earlier the equation of the tangent line, which is y equals 3/2 x plus 25 over 2. So let's go back to the menu of the graph mode and let's input this function. We have 3/2 plus 25/2. Then press X and notice again, that the highlighted row will go to the next row, which is Y3, meaning you can input another, but we are, for this problem, we'll just grab the two of them. So press draw, the graphs of the two will appear, and as you can see on the screen, the line in red will intersect the curve in blue at that one point. Let's see if that point is the point given -3/8, so we can actually solve for the intersection. So the intersection is here, so to get to that, press F5, and of course, the point of intersection given is -3/8. Okay, actually, there's an easier way to get the equation of the red line even without going to the run matrix mode and manually solving for the equation of the line. Although we know that the answer here is y = 3/2 x plus 25/2 here, or 1.5 x plus 12.5. So the CG50 has a special feature to get the equation of the tangent line to a curve at any point. So let's deselect y2. So you can see only y1 is highlighted, meaning only the graph y1 will be shown in the screen when we press draw. So there is only the blue line, the blue curve. So let's just trace, shift, and sketch. Press sketch, F4. As you can see, this will appear. And these are more options to get the characteristics of a curve. You have here the tangent, the normal, the inverse. So the problem is about the tangent line. So press tangent and press. As you can see, the green line is the tangent at the point 0, 10, and just the problem is at the point -3/8. So let's look for -3/8 there, and this green line is the tangent to the blue curve at the point -3/8. So pressing X again, this will happen. The exact equation, the tangent line, will appear in the bottom left of the screen. Press X there. So you see the curve here is y = 1.5x plus 12.5. And you know it's the same as this, 1.5 or 3/2 and 25/2 or 12.5. That's it. So there are many more features of the CG50 that we can explore. Let's do that again next videos. Thank you.